My long journey through the family court system has brought me here to you to tell you that there's only one way that we're going to stop hundreds of thousands of children from dealing with the same nonsense that I had to deal with. Though the family courts claim to be out for the best interest of the children, I think that we all know differently. In my eyes, the best interest of the children is equal parenting, 50-50 visitation. There is no other way for a child to grow up happy, at all. I believe that if we do a 50-50 visitation, the courts will have no choice but to become uninvolved. They won't be able to be involved because we'll be taking care of it ourselves. Children want and need both of their parents. I wish that my parents had split custody equally. Divorce is hard enough without a child having to deal with hearing their mother and father fight over money and who's going to have them and watching their father get arrested for non-payment of child support. The judges and lawyers seem to look at people as ATMs rather than as people who have real emotions. It's obvious that the best interest of the child is thrown aside as the lawyer's bills grow and grow and grow. For 6 months, I didn't see my dad. And I told my attorney when we went back to court that when we go there, I want you to say, okay, she can see her dad now. And he said, I don't care what you say. Your mom's the one paying me. I'm not helping you. What you want is irrelevant to me. I watched for 2 years as my dad got divorced from his ex-wife, watched as he struggled every single day to stand up, to drive a stick shift to these kind of rallies that we're at right now. Last time I talked to him, he was a walking skeleton and had just been released from jail for a non-payment of child support by Judge Fred Kaiser, who told my dad to shut up and remanded him to jail for a week, 3 weeks before he died. He was a well-known father's rights activist in New Jersey who was beaten down by the system and was, in the end, completely defeated. His family life was destroyed, his financial life was destroyed, his social standing, everything. And he dedicated his every waking moment to fighting the system and making sure that his kids would have a better life because he found out that he was diagnosed with Lou Gehrig's disease, a stress-related illness, that he had 2 to 5 years to live. When he got out, he was just a skeleton, basically. He had no body structure to him. All of his muscles were gone. We spent some time together, and I had a conversation with him, basically, you know, that you would have with someone when you know they're going to die. On August 12th, he called me and said he was going to give me his last $200 to fix the car that he had gotten me. He never called back, and he was supposed to show up to Eatontown to see me. The next day, I had a gut feeling that something was really wrong with him, and my grandfather went to go see him and discovered his dead body. He had fallen asleep and stopped breathing. So I found out I was the last person to talk to him. It took me till now, really, to be able to talk about it without crying. And even still, it's kind of hard. But I'm out here now picking up the torch from where he left off. I'm not going to let his death go in vain.
Let's look at some statistics. 85% of all children that exhibit behavioral disorders come from fatherless homes. That's from the Center for Disease Control in Washington, D.C. 90% of all homeless and runaway children are from fatherless homes. The source is the Department of Health and Human Services report out of Washington, D.C. 71% of all high school dropouts come from fatherless homes. And that's from the National Principals Association report. 75% of all adolescent patients in chemical abuse centers come from fatherless homes. And 63% of youth suicides are from fatherless homes. 80% of rapists motivated with displaced anger come from fatherless homes. 70% of juveniles in state-operated institutions come from fatherless homes. 85% of all youths sitting in prisons grew up in a fatherless home. That's from the Fulton County, Georgia jail population and the Texas Department of Corrections. Bottom line, without both parents' involvement in the children's lives, there's a lot of memories lost. there's a big part of that security network that disappears, evaporates. It's not just the father or the mother. It's the father's father and the father's mother. It's the father's uncle and the father's sister. And it's all that infrastructure we call family. And we are destroying half of the family. It's incredible.